Our top story tonight, millions of people choosing to stay on federal disability benefits even though they are fully able to work. Now, that's according to a blockbuster story today in the Washington Examiner. The news comes as the Social Security Administration publishes the latest figures on the number of Americans drawing disability checks. More than 76,000 workers went on disability just this month, bringing the total this year alone to 534,000, and altogether a record 10.9 million people are drawing a federal disability check. But clearly, some of them shouldn't be. With us now, Luke Rosiak, investigative reporter for the Washington Examiner, who uncovered these new numbers and is going to tell us about them right now. Luke, thanks for coming on the show tonight. How did you find these numbers, and tell me some of these surprising facts?
In 2009, the federal government was making a push to get some of these people off the disability rolls and get them back to work. So they did a survey about their work habits, and what they found is that they didn't really have any.
Wow.
You ask these people why they're on disability, and a lot of them said, it's not so much that I'm disabled, it's that I can't find a job, so I went on disability. So then the next question they asked them is, so what have you done to find a job? And virtually none of them said that they had contacted employers, looked at job ads, or done anything. The other thing is they said, okay, so you're disabled, so have you been to a doctor recently? Virtually none of them had visited a doctor in the last year. Very few of them had ever undergone a medical procedure to address their disability.
Luke, let me show our viewers some of the numbers behind your research here. This is your stuff. So there are two kinds of people on disability, right? People who are workers and people who have never worked. And a lot of the people who have never worked, they're disabled. They're fully disabled. Some of them having real problems. So take a look at this. 71% of those who have worked say returning to work is not a goal. 60% of those non-workers say returning to work is not a goal. These are extremely high numbers. This seems to me to be a way of life. What do you say?
It is a way of life. And unlike other entitlement programs like welfare, there's no time limit. So you look at these people, the SSI recipients, who haven't paid in. A lot of them have never worked a day in their life. And they're on food stamps, care, Medicaid, all of which can help cover some of their expenses. But they're not on welfare because there's a five-year time limit on that, which is exactly the reason why we're seeing some of the growth in this program.
It's unbelievable. Okay, so here's another startling fact from your research. 72% of these recipients who started a job while on disability got cash under the table. So they're getting the federal benefit, many of them, the majority of them, and then also getting paid. So this is really a scheme. It's a scam, isn't it?
Well, there's an incentive to take part-time jobs where you can get paid cash, or you can get paid over the table, but it's you're working few enough hours that you don't cross the limit where you become ineligible. So these people are working, and I've talked with people who say that they intentionally limit the amount of work that they do so that they can continue collecting this check.
Well, I know from your research what you found is a lot of people don't want to go back to work because they'll have no health care. Of course, that won't be true down the pike here because of Obamacare. But it seems to me this is an easy way out for a lot of people. What does it do to a program that is really, it's broke anyway?
Well, everyone who is on this program because they don't want to work is harming people who really need it, which honestly looks like it's a pretty small component of this program. But, you know, it is not intended to be an unemployment program, which is exactly what it's become. The determination for whether you're disabled hinges as much on whether you're able to gain a job as your health condition. So if you are overweight and have mobility problems and you have a college degree, a judge will rule that you're not disabled because you can sit at a desk and do advanced work. Whereas they consult this book that's really, it hasn't been revised in decades, and it looks up the availability of jobs for people without college degrees and high school degrees, which is most of these people. And 43% of SSI recipients don't even have a GED. The only thing you can do is work in the factory. So if you're not in top shape, then you're disabled.
Well, that's a very broad definition, I suppose. The numbers are disturbing, and to see more and more people on all kinds of government benefits, I think a lot of taxpayers out there say it's got to be a different way. Luke, thanks for coming on tonight.